Hello, it's Keith from KMAs Korner. I am back on my single player world where Keith plays. What do I play? Well, hopefully Minecraft. Keith plays Minecraft. And behind me there, you see the top of the villager breeder that I had worked on last episode. And there's our librarian. Our super awesome librarian with this Death Strider 3 boots. But let's go see if anybody has been born. It's been, I've played probably 20 minutes to an hour on the server. It's kind of hard to tell since the last episode. So as you see, we are starting to get a population of people here. So this thing is working perfectly. I haven't been trapping any yet because I got the gate closed over there. But right now we got two little baby ones, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, I want to get twice as many in there, 10, and then I will, let me see if I can see it, open that gate there so any more babies that are formed will fall and be sucked up over there. And I think I just rammed a sheep in its butt. So, the reason for people to want villagers, there's a few different ones. One is to trade with them, which is what I'm gonna do, over there near where you see the melon and pumpkins. I'm gonna make a place. I'm gonna get the best villager for every piece that I think I'm gonna need to trade for and give them a home over there and make a little trading shop. So that is one thing that you do with villagers. You can also use villagers for mob traps, you know. Another good reason for villagers is to make golem farms. So that is our project of the day. And I started making one last night, and it's the next morning. And a structure like this, I mean, it's not done, obviously. This has taken me like 20 minutes. So these things are pretty easy to make. I've made a bunch of them in my time playing Minecraft. And I'm gonna make, obviously, another for this server or area. So basically, these are the villager holding pens. You're gonna want, I think, 10 per level. At least 10, I think that's what it is. And there's our farm. It's getting ready to be harvested again. Maybe during this episode I'll harvest it. Still don't have enough nether wart, but that's okay because this nether wart that you see here will be 10 times more than I'll ever need for this whole series on this, or this whole world map in the future, because, you know, you can only make so many potions. They should be able to do something with nether wart, like you can combine them and make some sort of block. If you place the block, it like scares blazes or something, it makes them run away, I don't know. They need to do something more with nether wart. So, basically, quickly, you go up 10 to 15 blocks, see if I can do this, from the ground. So I made these four pillars on the corners, you don't need all four. There you go. And then you make a 20 by 20 structure. And then what I do is make the two high walls. I think I'm going to go in here. I make the two high walls inside the 20-20 structure. Then I put torches here. Before you put the water in, after you have your 20 by 20 structure, you have these things in the corner. So you put four blocks like this. And then you fill in all the waters up to the block. So each corner where you see this elevated thing, you have one of these. So you fill in these water blocks in between these things. Then you take these things out. And it creates a water stream going inwards. Like that. And all you do to make it work is just take a water block, a water source block, and place it there, and that means everything will be headed towards the center. You see how this corner, everything kind of goes towards the center. That's kind of how you do the water stream. So once you get the water stream up, you gotta find the places for the doors. So what I do is I extend the walls too high on each corner, and then you put down 6 doors, then 6 blocks, then 6 doors. Because each side is 20 wide, so 6 is 12, is 18, then the 2 end pieces will make it 20. So you just do that for every corner, then you just layer it. And that's what this is up there, which is the next floor that you see there. Something you can do when you're placing doors is you can jump and click, and you end up landing like a block higher than everything else. So if you're stuck down there and you need to get up, you jump and place a door and you land a block higher, then you can just jump again and you jump your way out. So that's kind of a sneaky little trick that you can do. So basically, these things, the villager holders, you can do how there's many different designs on them. And this is just the design I like to use. And I just make a platform that is 6 blocks and 6 blocks. Basically mirrors the 6 blocks that are in between the 2 sets of doors. You need some raise the walls too high. Eventually there's going to be a water stream in there to keep all the villagers in one area. And I think you put a glass roof on it. I gotta look that up. I haven't gotten that far yet. I don't have all these things by memory. So that's basically how you do these. These are really easy to make. So there's no excuse if you are playing single player and you have villagers. There's no excuse. I mean, I even say instead of mining, sometimes it's almost better to get villagers and you can trade, you know, make the farms and trade a lot with the villagers. It's a great way to get a whole bunch of things I like to get from villagers basically are books, so I can put stuff on my axes and stuff. It's always nice to be able to trade, you know, like 24 emeralds and a book for a Fortune 3 book, because it's awesome. Or have a villager that you can get Unbreaking 3 from at any time that you want. Those things are imperative if you want to be a boss in this game. Ooh, it's a full moon. Yeah, baby. Yeah. So, I am going to go finish this farm. Check out how my villagers are more breeding and maybe open the gate so I can start collecting some to put in this farm. Then, maybe next episode or an episode afterwards, I will teach you how to trade with villagers to get the best that you need to get. Because I've watched some people trade recently, and it's like, really? Why are you buying all that cake? You don't need to buy all that cake. Once in a while, you have to buy something, but it's usually glass and stuff. And 90% of the villagers you're going to get, you're not going to want. You really only want librarians and farmers to get the emeralds and the librarians to get the books that you want. Butchers and all those, they're good, but they're not really worthy for anything. So a lot of people waste their time getting the best things. There's monsters nearby. There's usually a skelly back here. You went for a ride. So, I'm gonna go to sleep and fix that hole. Oh, gotta love Minecraft. And I'll be back. Alright, I am back. I have finished this layer. And I have set up the support. Yes, that's very high. For the next layer. So basically, what I do when I do these things, about 15 blocks up for the first layer. Then from there, I go 60, 61 blocks, I think I went this time, to the second. So, let me climb this long ladder of, oh my god, please don't fall off, and show you how to make a layer on this. The view is simply amazing up here, above the clouds. Yeah. So what you do when you're up here, I make this 2020 20 by 20 layer again. So basically what I'm doing is making the floor to put the water on. So as I put a ring around it, yeah, that's the second time in a couple of videos I've referenced that song, and no, I'm not a big, whatever. So let me finish this up and I'll get right back with you. Now I'll just speed this up. Alright, so I made this floor, and I had to go downstairs to look what I had to do next because my memory sucks. But basically, once the floor is down, you just build a too high wall around the whole thing. And again, I will get back to you when this is done. Okay, so the too high wall is done, and this is where you're going to be putting the water. So, as I showed you in the last little segment, that I put these four little blocks in each corner. I apologize for the rain. I won't remove the rain because I don't do things like that in this series. And basically, you want to make... water sources at all the corners, on all the walls. So I'm gonna do that and I'll get back with you. Alright, click my torches, and now you see all the walls have a water source block flowing down the middle, and then you have these edged ones flowing right towards you, so if anything gets stuck in this weird place where they intermingle, they will still push the golem towards the center. And then there's that big drop down to the lava blade down there, which I still haven't made the lava blade yet, but I wanted to show you how to make one of these floors. And I kind of showed you this before. You take out the four blocks and you put one there, and as you see, it pushes me away. So let me do that for the other sides. If you see, the water flows towards the corner now, but as soon as I put a block there, let go of the controllers, it pushes me away. Alright, so those are up now. So the water on this level is done. There'll be one more level to build, but I first have to make the doors and stuff, and real quickly before I go to work, I'm going to show you that. Then when I come home from work, I'm going to finish up the farm and give you an idea of how it works and stuff. So in the corners, I like to do that. Because it kind of has the same design. Oh, this farm is in two different biomes since it's raining only in part of it. Also, you need to build this inside your spawn chunks because then it will be actively working all the time. I really hope I have enough cobble here. So what I do is call in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then I put in 6 double highs here. 3, 4, 5, 6. If I did this right, there should be 6 left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now you need at least 48 doors. And so what you need to do is place them on the outside. So you face in, you look down, you place them. Alright, so the doors are up, and I just realized I forgot one major important thing, just because you don't want any spawns in here. I go one to the right and just of this weird water block, and I just skip a block, and I put torches every other block. This just ensures that nothing's going to really spawn. So that kind of gave you a quick idea on how to build these. Real quickly, you do want to build these pods on the side, I guess. Why not? I'll build one real quick. Then I definitely got to go, or at least build the outline of one. You go out 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 from the edge of the last door. Then you go over until the edge of the other last door. Can I reach? No. So this would be the pod. You fill this in with cobble. I don't have any on me. So the floor is the same level as this. And what I do is build this up over here just for design looks. Like that. And then you take the cobble and make a 2-high wall around this whole thing. Put water sources in each of the 4 corners so it pushes in the middle. Put a couple of torches, one there and one there, and cover it in glass. And I'll show you, I may show you how to finish this up later. But I do have to go to work. So let's go for a fall. Enjoy. Yeah, that's always a little scary. I'll be back and I'll show you more. It's morning again, you know what that means? It's time to harvest some crops. Well, let me go see if everything's ready. I'm pretty sure it is because I've been working so much on that. And yeah, everything up here is A-OK ready. Still need to get enough nether wart to fill that up, but who, even this amount of nether wart, who actually goes through all that? So flick a button. We got the stuff coming. I should have timed this tick-wise to see how long it takes. Let's go. I'm just seeing how much stuff I have in here before stuff filters. Ooh, torches. Let me put the... Okay, so this is obviously working now. Excellent. Let's see if anything's getting stuck. Because before, I used to get things stuck on the corners here. That's why I made these walls a little higher. And as you see, I put little stairs or ladders in each section so I don't have to trample as much. And it seems like nothing has gotten stuck. So, this is looking pretty good. I'm going to let it filter for a while and show you the end result. Unfortunately, it looks like it only sorts one item at a time. So right now it's doing the lapis, which I think needs to be fed some chicken. And it's not doing anything else yet because I only have one string of hoppers coming in here, so that's why it's taking so much longer. And that's why I thought this thing was broken initially. So it will take a while for all the products to get in there. And also, one last thing I wanted to show you, and I want to make sure there's no creepers here. I showed you the setup. And as you see, this lights off for the hoppers, I guess. I mean, for the... for the nether wart. Yeah, there it goes through. That's why that lights off. When I showed you how to make this thing, and I told you the comparators go through, come out the filtering ones, and I showed you putting the torches underneath here, I forgot that one major thing here that you needed to see. There's repeaters underneath that block. And it sounds like my cat is really interested in those repeaters. Every morning he says hi to me. And he's saying hi to me. He's like, why are you recording right now instead of playing with me? Well, I like doing this as much as I like playing with you, Gordy. Have some patience. So I'm going to wait a little while for all that to get sorted, and we'll see what my bounty is. See if this whole thing was worth it. And yeah, I'm pretty sure it will be. Alright, so I'm back on top of this huge, totally high up golem farm to kind of finish what I was showing you a couple of minutes ago. I got some blocks so I can finish this up. So what I was saying is you make these pods for the villagers to hang out in, and they are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Basically what I do is I take the edge of the where the doors and these blocks end, and I just take the farthest edges of the blocks and build out. And so I fill up their pod and I put a couple of torches, because we don't want mobs to spawn up here at all. And then what we need is the water, so we can hit water in all the four corners, and what that does is push the villagers to the center. Okay, and you see how it just pushed that block to the center. So let's get some more water. And then we want to cover this up. There will be blocks here. So I'll just use one there to cover this up. I'm trying to think if I'm forgetting something before I do this, but I'm not. And of course when there's villagers around, you do not want anything to spawn. So what I do up here and everywhere on the spawner is, put half slabs so nothing spawns. I'm not going to put one there because I'm going to use a track to get a villager in there. Oh. My farm down there is still doing its thing, separating all the items. So what I am doing now is going to finish this floor here. Alright, seeing I do not have the blocks to finish up the floor, and I've already have enough speeded up parts on this video, I just wanted to show you what you do next so you kind of get the idea. I just make the wall on top of this, what are those? Doors, like this. And I make the second layer of this particular thing that's underneath us with the water. So once this is all filled in, I'm not gonna do it, I'm just gonna put up one wall right now. Once this is all filled in, seeing we're way up high, mobs are gonna spawn up here really quick and easy. But once the wall is all filled in, you can fill all this in with water just like you did down there and cut out the center holes. And, no you don't. And once the center holes are filled in, cut out, you can start finishing up the pods and getting the villagers in. But let's go see if this kills me. No, it did not. Imagine that. So, this might. No, that wasn't too high, I guess. I know I don't have feather falling on, so that was kind of scary. But, let's see what's going on over here. We got some carrots. We got a shit ton of that. And the wheat is still filling up. So, it's been two full days in the... item sorter is still working at it. So that gives you an idea how much crop is created here. So one crop basically is a half a double chest of material, which is more than enough to trade with the villagers. But I'll be back one more time with that finished without the villagers in it, just so you can see what it's like. And I think I'm going to replant the crops. Have you ever had a villager breeder stop working? Hello, sir.
Hi, how you doing? Hi.
Well, mine was working, obviously, because I got a few villagers in there, and I got this from 2 to 10 villagers. The first thing you want to check out to make sure that everything is okay, that you don't have any doors within 100 blocks of the village. And the village is actually up there. You can't see it right now, but my golem farm is more than 100 blocks away, so that's not the issue. But I think I figured out what the issue was with these particular guys. Their inventories are full. And so without inventory, they're not going to share their supplies. They're not going to share to the other villagers, which is the first... Excuse me, sir. Thing that they do to get in the mode for breeding. So if they're not sharing their product, they're not going to be breeding. Hi. No. I said no. Really? You're just really persistent, aren't you? Mm-hmm. Will you stop that? Come on, man. Okay, I'll let you do that. So what you gotta do is come in here, and when they're trying to replant the crops, just steal them. Steal from the villagers, and their inventories will eventually run out, and you can... and they should start sharing and breeding again. Let's see if anybody's sharing. But I don't know what happens to, like, the clerics and the people who do not farm. If you can empty their inventory. But this guy's sharing. He's sharing with me. I'm such a meanie. So, we'll give this thing time. And... Hey, guy. Mr. Cleric, man. You're in my way. And another way to get them going again is to trade with them. I think I'm going to steal some more carrots. I've probably stolen about 10 stacks out of here. I like to use carrots because potatoes are such better food. The only thing that carrots are really good for... is to make golden carrots. So hopefully I have just... taken enough product away from them so they'll start breeding again. We'll see. But probably not in today's episode. Because this episode's gonna end before that happens. Aww. I don't know if I have actually shown you this before. But, I know I've showed you this room, but I don't know if I've shown you this guy. If you have a slime chunk, and I gotta stick one over here because this is where I'm finding a lot of the slimes. Because this is a chunk, and that is a chunk, so of course I cut out this one by accident. So, you can throw some sand down, put a cactus on it, put a half slab, make an iron golem above them, and keep them enclosed with the fences. Stick hoppers all around here to go towards a chest, and you get slime balls. I think I've seen a total of 4 slimes down here, one of them big and the 2 smaller ones, but at the same time, I still have slime balls, and I made enough sticky pistons for another couple of stacks of slime balls. So this does work, even though I hardly ever come down here, and it's not really efficient because most of the slimes spawn over here, and they don't see this guy. But it's a really good thing to do if you do find a slime chunk, if you don't need like millions of slimes all the time. But the thing that you need to do first is have this slab here and the cactus, I guess, underneath. Put the fences around, get above the fences, and get one block higher than the slab and make your golem. Just make sure the golem is made above the fences, because once he's made, he'll fall. And why is he keeps becoming invisible to me? Invisible. Okay, enough of that. But make sure when you make him, he falls, because if he can't make him inside the fences, you gotta make him above, so the gravity will pull him down into the fence, which is something that's good. But it's a really simple way to get a few extra slime balls. I mean, most people make these huge ass farms that you can get 10 million slime per minute. Who needs to get 10 million slime per minute? You just need a couple of stacks of slime balls every little while in the game. So those are good. So I'm going to go over and see what we got from our harvest on the big farm. It's done sorting its stuff. So yeah, I'm going to put the carrots that I just stole from the villagers in here. So you see the fruits of the last crop. How many? Why do these keep getting in there? I gotta figure out what's going on with that. Something keeps going on with my stupid nether wart. But, you know, that's enough to last a server. So I think I've replanted everything. Oh yeah, I've replanted everything. And it's ready to go again. Shows you how much time flies when you're having fun. So, yeah, might as well do another harvest while we're waiting. Because I need this stuff for when the villagers decide to breed and be ready to be exploited for their materials. Look at all those yummies. Potatoes. I wish I had the frying pan right now so I could fly these up and eat them. Yum yum. Yum yum. Yum. Ooh. I got a hoa place over there, it looks like. I think everything's done. I'm not going to... Maybe not. I forget. Soul sand is slow sand. When I first started playing this game, we had the sand, and there was really no name for it, so we called it slow sand instead of soul sand, because that's what it was. It was slow. And as you see, I think all the crops are in. So we'll let that sort its way out. It unfortunately takes a long time. But that's okay. I don't need the speed. And I have finished this. Other than putting in the villagers, so let me speed all the way up. So as you see, this is all done. All ready to go. All I need to do is put a couple of villagers in each one. I need 10 villagers, I think, per layer, so I need 20 total, because this is 2 layers. And I was thinking initially when I first did this that I was gonna combine, make 2 more over there and combine a connection path which would connect to those droppers there, so all of the iron and stuff would go to this farm too. I haven't completely decided against it yet, but I think it would be a good idea. As you see, we are very high up. So you gotta be careful up here. And this is the end of the episode. I'm glad that you are here to watch me build my golem for them. They're really not that hard. They're just a little intensive with the blocks. And so I hope you liked this episode. Next episode, we'll get the villagers in here and hopefully start getting some golem. But to then, bye. Oh no. Oh yeah.